Hello folks, Richard Moore. And this video is entitled, well, I don't know what we're going to call it yet, but we are going to talk about murder, mafia, and of course moonshine. As we approach July the 6th, I think it's proper for me to readdress something that I've talked about. I've written about this in one of my blogs, and you can see that it's all lowercase, Richard Moore, SCDA. At WordPress.com. I think it was reposted on Facebook. And to be honest with you, I can't. It's difficult to keep up with all that. On July the 6th, 2001, was Sheriff Harold Ray Presley's last day. And so many people, of course, in North Mississippi should know the name Harold Ray Presley. Moreover, his first cousin, Elvis Presley, which is known the world over for obvious reasons. And I'm going to talk about some of those things. I want to clear up I have not had any direct communication pertaining to this with any of the Presley family. I have met a couple of members of the family. And so I just know that there's not a backstory with someone within the family that's had a conversation with me about this. I welcome that, by the way. But that hasn't happened. So for those that want to know the rest of the story about Priscilla and Charlene, and had it been different, Charlene would have never divorced Elvis. And is there a story there? We'll save that for another time. Now, you know, some stories have to wait. But this story can't wait. I think it's there's a lot of disturbing elements about the death surrounding Harold Ray Presley. Yeah, Harold Ray is born and raised right here in North Mississippi. He dropped out of high school in the ninth grade, which during that time, that was common practice. People, they dropped out of school. It was either that or starved to death. And chances are he probably saw fit to probably work and get a job. And lo and behold, the United States government found him a job and he got drafted. And later on, Harold Ray got his GED. And he ran for sheriff. Had he not been murdered, I have no doubt in my mind that he would still be the sheriff of Lee County, Mississippi. And Lee County, Mississippi would be a different place than it is today, in a good way. Nothing about the way Lee County Sheriff's Department and the way law enforcement is carried out in North Mississippi can be considered a reflection of Harold Ray Presley. He did things different. It's almost impossible to find a photograph of Sheriff Presley in uniform. his typical attire was a white shirt and khakis. He wasn't the kind of guy that wanted to have all of the badges, and he didn't even wear the little cute polo shirts like the sheriff does now. The casual Friday stuff, but it's every day. And he is not a reflection of his former boss. When I look at this and the things that have come against the family since the murder of Harold Ray, I draw some stark comparisons to other stories, and one that's eerily similar and, in my opinion, definitely connected the same elements of crime. Many may have heard of the Dixie Mafia. Very few and fewer people have heard of the State Line Mob. And these people controlled the vice and the crime along the Mississippi, Alabama, and Tennessee state line. And of course, members and elements of that right here in Lee County, Mississippi. Union County, Alcorn County, Tishomingo, Prentice. When they went, it was a manhunt for this kidnapper or whatever he had done. Stone is his last name. And on the call, of course, the sheriff was there. He did have a bulletproof vest, but he was a big old boy. As a matter of fact, when I believe Brandon, his nephew, I may get some of the relationships off a little bit, but hey, was running for mayor. Harold Ray told him, he said, "Now, there's going to be a lot of people come to you that want you to do things that are not right, bad things. And all you need to do is remind them that you have a 300-pound uncle that will put them under the jail." And folks, I have no doubt in my mind that that very thing would have happened. 5 years consecutively, Harold Ray earned the Buford Pusser Award of Excellence. And if you know anything about Buford Pusser, he'd wear a uniform either. He had his own way of dealing with corruption and crime. He didn't sit down at the table with the enemy and try to reason with them. He said, "You either shut it down, oh, I'm going to shut it down." When his own deputies couldn't find a backbone, Buford Pusser didn't matter, because he had enough backbone for his whole department. He didn't need a gun. He had a big stick, and I promise you, in Buford Pusser style, he shut down these beer joints, juke joints on the state line there in his county, even though they were heavily guarded and protected by the state line mafia. Cold-blooded killers, if you will. And so goes the rest of the story. growing up in North Alabama, in Franklin County, wasn't far from some of the very elements. And the kingpins, if you will, of the state line mafia. That being the Dawson family, DeWitt Dawson being one of them. Years later, DeWitt was arrested, and I don't believe that many federal and state agents had ever, before or since, converged that deep in any territory as they did North Alabama when they set out to finally take the Dawsons down. But DeWitt turned to a preacher in Kilby, state prison in Alabama. And he had many conversations about the Corvette, a crash that killed him, and there was another deal. In other words, his wife was not supposed to have been with him. I mean, he had details that only someone on the inside would have had. Pals had details that were never released about the Corvette. I know that the Corvette was purchased from Gene Crump Chevrolet in Tuscumbia, Alabama. A family member, which will remain unnamed, he's no longer with us anyway, that did the investigation on behalf of MIC, Motors Insurance Corporation, which is a subsidiary of General Motors, and GMAC. In those days, you could finance with GMAC and also get your insurance, and that kind of broke that deal up. But as a senior investigator, I asked that question as a child, but more than once, about the particulars of what they found and didn't find when they did the forensics and everything on this vehicle. It had been a year since that fateful day, August the 21st. It was in the 70s. He still wouldn't talk about it. These questions were posed, at least 10 years or better after that happened. And to my knowledge, I don't think any of that information, and it's just something that is not popular to bring up. What's that have to do with Harold Ray? Well, to get the Buford Pusser Award, he obviously fit the model of who a genuine peace officer or a genuine sheriff and how they behaved. And so I would say that Harold Ray Presley falls into that. He spearheaded the DARE program and was fully behind treatment programs and so forth for those addicted to prescription drugs and what have you. And he was also very passionate about eradicating that problem as far as his county was concerned. I promise you today, folks, it's 1,000 times worse than it was when Harold Ray was sheriff. That's a fact. Are we better off? Are we safe? Are we more safe now than we were when Harold Ray was the sheriff? I think we all know the answer to that. we've got a politician. We don't have a true lawman at the helm. Now, we know that when John F. Kennedy was assassinated, and the guy that assassinated him, Lee Harvey Oswald, I believe it was a patsy. I don't believe he had anything to do with it. And God forbid he be around too long to talk about it, you know. That's when Jack Ruby showed up and shot him coming out of the courthouse. And so we'll never know what would or wouldn't, but that's how that story ended. And of course we know that Jack Ruby and his Chicago mafia affiliation, and then their redheaded stepchild, the Dixie Mafia, and the State Line Mob. And they have a way of shutting people up. So who is our Lee Harvey Oswald? Well, I'm going to say it would be Stone. This was the man that was said to have unloaded his weapon on the sheriff and murdered Harold Ray Presley. Well, the initial chatter that came out over the police radio during this thing happened to be intercepted. It happened to be that Mississippi Highway Patrolman was close. He was the closest one, that he was the first one on the scene outside of those that were already there. This was not in the plan. They didn't anticipate that. Who didn't anticipate that? Members of Lee County Sheriff's Department did not anticipate that. That shouldn't have been a problem, should it? No. Well, that was a problem. Once the highway patrolman arrived, he immediately secured the crime scene as it pertains to Stone laying there, of course, dead. No, he wasn't. Yeah. He was dead. I believe it was Deputy Dillard that made that happen. Why? He killed our sheriff. Dillard's a hero. Well, he was charged and acquitted for violating the civil rights there. You know, when they, so the highway patrolman, the first thing he did was place bags, sealed bags, and taped them around both of Stone's hands. And when they did the autopsy and the forensic examination of Stone, zero gunpowder residue was found. In other words, Stone never fired a weapon. So if, and like Oswald, he didn't get to live near as long as Oswald did. Our Jack Ruby is Deputy Dillard, which, by the way, is still, even though he was, the Department of Justice believed so much that he murdered this Stone, he violated his, but he was acquitted. Maybe that was pomp and circumstance. I don't know. Do I believe that they had it right, but should have got a conviction, but they didn't? Sure. That's disturbing because he's still there. I've got a federal lawsuit right now, and Dillard happens to be. I didn't know the backstory on Dillard. We already know he's got that murder under his belt. Who knows how many others he has under his belt. But he sure had his sights on me, because I'm talking about things, friends, that the only reason I'm alive is because of the God I serve. And my God is not Jim Ace Johnson. You can believe that. My God is not my own personal self-interest. My motto is not I protect and serve my personal self-interest. Did we and do we have illegal vice and gambling in North Mississippi? Absolutely. Absolutely. I'll end that part with that. So, there's a lot of people in Mississippi State Prison that are there because held Ray Presley. Honored the oath he took. And I'm going to tell you, he died honoring that oath. Perhaps that's the reason that so many pull their skirt up and dance around that oath now, because they know what really happens to people that when they swear on a stack of Bibles or a Bible to a God that they really believe in, on a Bible they have actually read, to protect a Constitution that they believe is the very foundation that holds this country up, and that without that, we would surely crumble. Those type of people are far and few between, ladies and gentlemen. And just because they take an oath and say those things does not mean they mean it. And all of you should know that. There's some constant absolutes in life. You know, everybody that's in prison . All of them are not guilty. Some of them are actually innocent, whether you want to believe that or not. People, everybody that says they're your friend are not. And sometimes we always learn it the hard way, but they're not your friend. And there's a whole lot of people that go to church that are not Christians. Now, we shouldn't have any problems agreeing on those things. This is the world we live in. And the numbers, these are not, well, there's a few bad apples. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know where that came from, but if I could stay with the apple theme, I'm going to say there's a few good apples. And those good apples know exactly what I'm talking about, because they're the ones that get marginalized and dismissed as being radical or a nut job, or that they're having some type of psychosis or whatever. They even get angry when people constantly try to dismiss them or ignore their voice because they're implying that something other than the truth is going on here. Maybe they're suffering from some type of psychosis. And when those good apples get hot, I tell you what, the world knows about it. Because a true good apple, I will tell you, folks, and I know a few, they're going to tell it like it is. And And when you cross them, maybe not the first time, maybe not the second time, catch them on the right day, or cross them on the wrong subject, and I promise you, they'll get in your ass like a bicycle with no seat. That's what they do. So, over 2 years later, on a not honest mistake, but bad things do happen. But understand this. There's a criminal element in law enforcement at the time these individuals murdered their boss. These individuals are still out there with badges. So we don't know the whole story. We don't know how Patrick Presley was going the wrong way and hit another oncoming vehicle on a four lane. I mean, the driver and the child, I believe both of them are dead, or at least one's dead. The driver, a woman, and I don't know how you don't see a car coming straight for you, okay? Was she distracted? Was she high on dope? I mean, you don't play chicken. It's a four lane. And it's four lane with a shoulder. I'm pretty sure that, sorry about that. I'm pretty sure that there was a ample room to, one way or the other. I know that that it wasn't as if Patrick had zeroed in on this car, and as they tried to move, he maneuvered with it till he could beat up. I mean, it wasn't like that. Now, Harold Ray, his daddy did have some enemies, and even people, judges and prosecutors. Yeah. He made it difficult for some of these smoke-filled backroom deals to take place as sheriff. A lot of people had an axe to grind. And when they target someone, it's the whole family. Those that are living right now, I'll guarantee you, they'll attest to this, that they feel like the sights have been set on them, and it's just too many things going on that's the only thing that can make any sense. So he sentenced, and they sent Patrick to Lafayette County Jail to wait to go to prison. That didn't make any sense. I mean, all things being even, I mean, his dad's dead. What were they afraid of? Were they afraid that Dillard or one of those guys would go in there and, his uncle, I believe, may have been the sheriff, Larry, or he'd get prep, or Larry might let him out the back door, suggested Larry was no good, questioning his integrity. I think that was a slap on the face, so they sent him to Lafayette County Jail. That's heaven on earth. It's like the ancient catacombs of Rome. It doesn't have a window in it. Maybe one window. I mean, people go to jail before they're ever just for being charged, you know. We heard a little thing that you're innocent until proven guilty. Now, you're not guilty by proxy because you have a prior. for those that don't understand that concept, I'm going to do another one on that, because we got some people, in, especially in Chickasaw County, that don't quite get that concept, but they're going to get it today, understand things. We got some people that on the plantation, stupidity down there for real. So they send him to Lafayette County Jail. And so, and I'm sure that he was fine probably over there. I mean, I suspect it's Buddy East. He was the sheriff. He's gone now. And Buddy probably knew Harold Ray. So I'm going to say that he was up. But what isn't okay is now you're going to send Patrick Ray Presley, the son of Harold Ray Presley, to a prison with a lot of people that are bitter at his dad, just like those that worked for his dad, because he was a little, he was throwing a monkey wrench in some people's deals. Yes. So, there's a lot of questionable things that happened. Of course, Mississippi State, it's been, the DOJ is looking at taking it under conservatorship for the second time. Because they just, there's no good story for these inmates to be dying, committing suicide, or being murdered, whatever they call it. Now, I know that there's a segment of you out there that that are Klansmen, even black Klansmen, that said, don't let them burn, kill each other. That's what they need. That's called unbridled hate. When you hear that spewing from somebody's mouth, it sure isn't something that Jesus would have said or condoned. He didn't say, Father, strike these heathens dead because they spit on me and pierced my side and whipped me and jammed these 3-inch thorns into my head, his blood running down, and spit on him and laughed at him and mocked him. And while he hung on that cross, he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. So, for you, Mr. and Mrs. Pillar of the Community, closet Klansmen, that think it's okay that were your forefathers that were saying, give us Barabbas. And ladies and gentlemen, they're still saying, give us Barabbas, but crucify him. I've always said a parent should never outlive their children. And so, Charlene has to bury her husband. I'm quite sure that she knows there's more than a fly in the ointment. I think that, I don't believe that Charlene's remarried. I don't know anything, but I kind of believe that, I don't think she is. I mean, not that she couldn't be or anything like that, but I think it'd be fair to say that she still loves Harold Ray. Ain't nobody gonna replace that. Of course, they're not gonna try. That's she's not either. And folks, you have to respect that devotion. Now, her child, knowing that they said that he hung himself, that I don't have any death threats and promises that he had already received that they would kill him. Of course, you know, who's he going to tell? A member of law enforcement, and most of the time, that's the fox guard in the hen house. They sent Harold Ray Presley's son. I believe it was intentional. I believe that the wreck was caused intentionally. I do not believe and won't believe. I've not read a transcript. I don't believe that Patrick was probably never completely clear, precisely clear about those moments there. Things that nobody could really put their finger on. I can put my finger on it. And it's something that nobody's talking about. But we're going to talk about it. We're going to talk about this covert shadow police force running at North Mississippi. And much of it, if not all of it, operates under the umbrella of community-oriented policing. And you think these are do-gooders wanting a safer neighborhood. So you're not associating them with murder for hire, drug trafficking, child trafficking, sex trafficking. Well, honey, you best associate it with it because that's real and alive and it's a thriving, and they're feeding on government grant money and they're doing it right here in North Mississippi. If Harold Ray Presley had been sheriff, I will promise you that dog wouldn't be hunting, not in Lee County. And he'd be putting other sheriffs in the adjacent counties on blast if they had their hands in that till. You see, Harold Ray had been a problem for what they wanted to bring in. Jim H., You People Johnson, touts having a stalking program. It's supposed to be for sex offenders. We're going to watch them. They're trying to grab kids off of merry-go-rounds. That's a good sales point. Nobody wants to see that. Yeah, we'll shoot them on sight. What he's not telling you is that's not a problem. He's not telling you they'll set people up and make them look like that to get the crap to, by default. You'll hate them. It's hard to tell who the real perverts are. But his little stalking program that even the attorney general, they just drool and drabble over it because these are the people that are getting reelected. This is how Lynn Fitch, that just buried into Ku Klux Klan royalty, is our attorney general. And Espy lost against her. How y'all feel about that now? Who you should have voted for? Is this just my opinion? No, this is what's really going on, boys and girls. Now, so we're going to send Patrick down there to Auschwitz, also known as Parchman. He gets the story, hang yourself. That was probably a physiological impossibility that could happen in that holding cell, but, you know, that's the story. Same story they gave my 18-year-old brother, 6'4", tied off to something that was 6 foot, and managed to hang himself. He was in an isolation cell. They're always in an isolation cell. That eliminates the witnesses to the lie. I've talked to parents and they just didn't. I got a picture of a young man in Amory that is in the coroner's office before they, you know, and you can't unsee that, but I can tell you. He had markings on his body. I saw the very clear markings of handcuff impressions. that were obviously too tight. But he wasn't in jail. He was at home. He'd been in jail 3 days prior to his death. Of not one bruise, scratch, or anything in the neck area. But he hung himself. Monroe County. I know it was a lie then about my brother. And I believe that the Preston family are dealing with two lies now. Two Presleys have been murdered. Now, has law enforcement got a little bit of an axe to grind with Charlene? I don't know if they do or they don't. I'm going to say they probably do. Jada. She did a year or so at the county jail. I think for biting a deputy. Now, really? You got bit. I mean, considering the fact that they murdered her dad, I mean, hell, they ought to let her made it on that, shouldn't they? Yeah. I bet one of his grandsons in passing. Or maybe Patrick's nephew, or maybe it was his dad. I'm not sure what the relationship is. Kobe. And this family has absolutely been the crosshairs for a long time. And will remain there. I don't know that they'll ever not remain there. There's not a certain way you can do things, and maybe you won't be in the crosshairs, including, but not limited to, raising the dead and walking on water. Jesus Christ did all those things. They couldn't get him to the cross fast enough. They couldn't wait. The devil had a field day. It was just like the community orgasmic policing mantra of today. That same crowd, give us Barabbas. They're riding around, blowing horns and stalking and creeping and setting people up and making people and knocking heads off. And most of the stories you get about these crimes and stuff that comes on it out of this comic book called The Daily Journal are from their Saturday Night Live version of news, WTVA and WCBI. Really, I mean, you couldn't take 1,000 of the worst that's ever been through Whitfield that... of the worst and set them down, and they'd be able to correct you on where you're getting information from the wrong place. I'm talking about some nut jobs. But you're not going to get the truth. And subscribe to this channel and share. I will promise you it's not going to be scripted. I'm not reading the news to you. And I'm going to tell it like it is. I'm not going to mince any words. And I'll tell you, people say, some of my language is offensive. You always say offensive to me. It's not a cuss word. It's a damn lie. It's amazing. That offends me, that language. You know what? Somebody sitting there lying on and getting my tax dollars burns my ass up. It's a little more than offensive, okay? And they're covering up murders on top of it and telling a lie on top of it. But yes, they get offended because of some of my language. And so, I'm not running for office. I'm not trying to win Mr. Popularity. So I give a tinker's damn. But I promise you one thing. I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to say, oh my gosh, you just said that. I shouldn't have not said what I'm saying. And so Stone's dead. Now the I believe that right immediately during that first 24 hours of that deal, that a prominent lawyer in Tupelo told the family, wrongful death, this is slam dunk, because Stone didn't have no residue. And he didn't kill. It might have been Stone's family. I don't know, but I can tell you one thing. The second 24 hours, this was on the weekend, Friday. They got Johnny Cochran calling, begging for the case. By Sunday, they couldn't even get a phone call returned. It changed. That wasn't interested in. What changes a person's mind like that? You see, some people, they're not dancing with the devil until they realize that the devil's going to dance with them if they try to buck the system. It's all fine and good until you cross one of them, and then they take care of you. Ask Jimmy Doug Shelton. But you can't ask him now. How all that happened. Everything's wonderful until it ain't. Because the big devil in the room, the big elephant in the room in North Mississippi, it may take us a while to get some of those names, but I know who their puppets are. Jim H. Johnson's one of them, okay? Sheriff over in Itawamba County. We keep on with that, okay? We keep on with that. People dying in these jails. Right now, as a matter of policy, people, inmates, are systematically beaten and tortured in Lee County Jail. When I spoke about this a little over a month ago, 5 days from that, they were in my yard. I'm in Union County. I mean, I thought it was a homecoming at a training academy for Dunkin' Donuts. There was so much law enforcement out here. I still have not got a clue what supposedly I did. Malicious mischief, which is a law professor said that, well, malicious mischief, Mississippi, Ole Miss. That's the code when it's you're pissed off and they done something you really don't like. You jaywalked too fast and they want to make it a felony. That's felony, malicious mischief for whatever. That's what that is. Beat it to fit, paint it to match. Of course, we got to have an incompetent and criminal district attorney and a drooling bozo judge to make all these things work, but you don't have to go far to get it. Maybe we'll do that list on the drooling bozos. Plenty of them. So they're not now. But all these people that run for office, kissing babies, and shaking hands and all that kind of stuff. I mean, they're not kissing babies anymore. They've just got people working for them that are raping them. and then more importantly, look, they're a child predator. And then they call their brothers and sisters at DHS, and we're going to take your kids because we know you're on dope. Because your friend came over there the day before that gave you the dope that you didn't want. What the heck? Then they miraculously pop up. This is how they set their little deals up. leverage and manipulate the children. They've got to keep NAMBLA happy and these predators happy. Fresh meat, right? TPS, tens and thousands of kids every year. They don't know where they are. They've lost them. They're unaccounted for. This is all public record, folks. This is not National Enquirer here. I'm talking about Mississippi, the dirty South, okay? Those think, well, we've arrived. All righty then. Y'all need to pull off of these game shows or whatever the hell, Kardashians, and cut the TV off, okay? Quit picking up that fake newspaper. They're not even good to put on. The best place for that Daily Journal is the bottom of a bird cage. But you know what? I'm an animal lover, and I don't think we should do that to birds. I mean, we don't know everything. You know, some birds talk, you know? And how do I know they can't read? Okay, we don't know that. They can read. My dog in here can read, so I guess a bird can. You shouldn't abuse them with that. Now, so we don't know. But we know community-oriented policing is the element behind. I'm going to tell you, it's the element behind that. You see, Al Ray brought this DARE program in, and that's just not big enough. And they want to really put a bite into this deal. They really want to put a bite in it. I'm telling you they do. If those that remember, with this program, they have McGruff, the crime dog, the cartoon. He says, take a bite out of crime. And so I'm telling you, these folks are relentless. I was in federal prison with a guy that was the voice for McGruff, the crime dog. I said, get the hell out of here. What? Folks, you cannot make this stuff up. That's a fact. They took a bite out of his ass, too. And they're still doing it. Well, I'm here taking care of you. That hand, listen, this is where they do it, folks. These people are cannibals. And they're lazy, moron simpletons. Of course they're going to bite the hand that feeds them. They're wild, unchurched heathens going to a fake church. We've got a cool preacher. He wears a t-shirt and flip-flops. You know, and he probably got body odor too. Preaching this new gospel, okay? Trying to be cool. And then the guy's wearing these man buns with his ponytail up like this. Trying to look hard. People like me see you, listen, we laugh, okay? Especially I do. All right? Because we know the only thing bad about you is your breath. Now, I want to, because we're approaching the anniversary of the murder, and it wasn't by Stone, it was by people within that their own department. You know, in a perfect world, or those who have a come to Jesus moment when they actually make that decision. You see, God tells us anything done, if it's done in secrecy, shout it from the rooftop. And that's called your First Amendment. And that's what they arrest me for. I'm going to keep doing it, by the way. But if we could just get Jim H. Johnson to go on and tell the story, tell the truth, we could get, and he knows. Dillard's still there. I mean, since you're a murderer, and you got off hook, but that does not say you're not a murderer. You murdered Stone, okay? He did not murder Harold Ray Presley. Well, but he done other things. That's not how it works. Why do we have a murderer riding around, protect and serve with the badge, guns, all the bells and whistles on our dollar? And yet, we've got the zombie apocalypse down there pulling the lever. And we got African Americans pulling the lever. for a Klansman. There's no yes but on that. You are pathetic. It's just not, nobody's got the vocabulary. I mean, it's just impossible. And so, I know that the family, and especially Charlene and are conscious of this. And no, he's not getting to see his grandchildren and all these things that these criminals are enjoying. But the good guys, and even their families, for those that worked with Haraway Prescott, Matt, I would never do anything wrong. Well, I don't see you doing anything right. I don't see you doing anything right. I don't see you taking up collections, pay it, taking care of his family. Would Harold Ray have taken care of his great-grandchildren? Would he made sure they wouldn't have wanted for anything? If he could have got, they'd got, would it been, are you doing that? You're not. Well, then shut up. Shut up. We don't need lip service. We don't need lip service. I think here in a few days, they're going to dedicate, there's a sign going to be on the exit. I don't have the date. I'm sorry, folks. Maybe I do. I don't. I'm sorry, it's soon. Maybe the 21st of next month. I don't know. They're going to be dedicating this interchange to Harold Ray Presley. It's Auburn Road and I-22 right there. I think it would be, and if I don't have some kind of a conflict or whatever, I'm going to try to make it a point to be there as well. But for those that didn't have plans for that date, look at it, get the date, and when I get it out, we'll post it in the comments section there. And I think it go there, show your support. For Harold Ray and his family. This is not, and I'm telling you, who won't be there. I do not want you to get this confused. This is about him and his family, okay? It's not about an agency. I'm going to tell you why it's not about an agency. State, federal, local. The way I see it, you've abandoned your duty. You have disrespected the citizens of Lee County, Mississippi. You've desecrated the Constitution and spit on the graves of the hundreds and thousands who died and bled to give us that Constitution that you don't think is that important to protect. When somebody uses unflattering free speech, you make up a cyber stalking charge and lock them up because you got another liar that'll lie. And it's lies, lies, and more lies. And the Bible I have said all liars will inherit hellfire and damnation. Don't forget that. Don't forget that. It's not you accidentally lied. This is called willful and purposeful sin. When you lie and you destroy God's children and those that are under attack are the least of these, whatever you've done to them, you've done it to him. God says, vengeance is mine and I'm satisfied. He knows exactly what he's doing. And it comes in ways you'll never anticipate. Might even be this guy talking to you right now, consider it for a moment. The one that you worked for years to discredit and to destroy. I'm here because God sees it fit. You made me unemployable. If it weren't for the donations, for those that support me, I'm gonna get texts in the mail and stuff like that. I've got some people out there that I say pray. God tell you what to do. And I leave it at that. And it's usually people that don't have it. Always the first ones there giving you what they have. Who gave the most? The rich man or the widow? They all assumed it was the rich man because he gave so much. Jesus said it was the widow. She gave everything. So, Harold Ray did the same. And they took his son as well. Till next time, God bless you. So, folks, right after I finished my video about Harold Ray Presley, got my composure back, I wanted to leave you with this. It's clear as water. Now, I want to tell you, there's, and this is not store-bought. I didn't make it. This is 130 proof corn liquor. He says it got a little bit of a strawberry hint to it. I grew up in Freedom Hills, Alabama, and my papa, he moved around in that in the hills there, and he was a moonshiner. So let me see if this is the real deal. Woo! I'm going to put the lid back on it. And let me tell you what. Heaven help us. That's the deal.